It's the
All right. Yeah, so we trophied with this deck last night. The McWinsauce control deck. And we've seen a lot of people testing it out. Played against it a lot in the leagues yesterday and today. Probably gonna be a popular choice this weekend. I made some tweaks to the sideboard from what we played yesterday. Adding Hull Breacher and Teferi. Null Run. Mostly cards that I like in the mirror, and then anti-combo cards. One of the awkward things about this hand is that if you turn two Leovold, you're actually like fetching yourself off of white, so you can't prismatic. Well, that's not true. This can get Tundra, right? Ignore me. Ignore me! I mean, I haven't been streaming it, but Daddy Flex. You can kind of draw your own conclusion some. Hey, Lars514, thanks for the $20 donation. My next pizza is on chat. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. That kind of makes me want to order pizza.
Oh shit, what up?
Yeah, I mean, if we Leovold here, it actually prevents that bobble draw, because they cracked on my upkeep. If they crack on their turn, then they'd be drawing on my turn. And then Leovold wouldn't stop that draw. We could also just ending the Emery. That's the other line that I like. Both good lines. The upside to playing the ending now is that we would be able to save the Leovold to potentially pitch to Force Negation. Oh shit, what up, Red Ferret says? Think the 19 months, Ferret. Yeah, again, they should be cracking that Mishra's Bauble. Crack it on their turn so they can draw on my turn. Maybe they just wanted to play to juice up the saga. Another line here that's kind of tempting is to loan back Misty. And then ending the Mox Opal, force them to crack Lotus Petal to activate the Urza's Saga. They kind of don't give a shit though, right, with the Emery in play, because they can just rebuy the Lotus Petal. Could use a Wasteland here. Real bad. Well, they're targeting me with the Bauble. I wouldn't have done that. I'll take it. Okay, ending's a great draw. Let's see.
Oh shit, what up?
Hmm. considering ending the Moxo Bowl, thinking about the ramifications of that. I think it denies them a saga activation. Not off the first saga, but off the second one. I just want to save the endings for the sagas, though, huh? The sagas themselves. Another white source here, so I can play two endings in one turn. Sylvan Library probably finds me something, though. Probably okay. Yeah, I might figure out some way to bring them back, Red 7. Maybe early next year. I would like to keep the strengths. The strengths of not doing song requests. And then also find a way for people to share music with the stream. I might do it where it's like just not linked to donations. I might do it where it's only, only done with channel points. This is why I didn't kill the Mox Opal. I thought there was a chance that they would have a second one. Yeah, something like that, Zodiac Brave. Something like that. Need to kill this retrofitter is a question. I could literally kill all their constructs right now. Wasn't working earlier, Evil Toaster. I'll give it a check. A sec here. Somewhere. do 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 do. They block. Then we exile Retrofitter Foundry and use Grist to kill the other construct. Deal with all that. I think I just got a Prismatic Ending, another construct token. And then I'm not sure if Grist should be downticking here or upticking. How many people find that line? What, the serving with Leobold? I don't know. What was I doing? Not sure about this edict at all. Like, I could just be chumping the current strike token. There's the trample generator though, right? The trample generator that could go with Saga here. We're only at 6. Unfortunately, that Dried Arbor's in our graveyard, so we can't, like, 2-4 it here in the Windswept Heath. Fetching before I uptick Grist, because there's like a YOLO chance that we hit Uro off the mill, which would be amazing, right? I did forget Yorian. Yeah, Yorian would have been a good card to put in my hand, huh? Very easy to forget. I need to just get in the habit of always popping it out. Always pop it out. I don't know if I've ever gotten Yorian when I wasn't streaming. Companions. Just like one more fucking thing to remember. There are zero insects in the deck for Grist. We are not Grist tribal. Oh, there we go.
Oye, mi mulata, no te...
I wonder if getting back Lum here was correct, actually. I guess I still can. Yeah, I think I like getting back Lum so that the we can play the Dryad Arbor out. Start playing a little faster. Actually, I'm just gonna dredge the loam so I can put it in my hand. Cause me to time out if I leave Lum in the graveyard. Yeah. Just fucking serve with the Euro. Just bring it back. So I'm trying to end the game as quickly as possible. So we could have put Yori into hand and cast Yori, and I think that also would have done it this turn. I don't like letting them untap with their Saga though, and I don't like leaving the Loam in the graveyard. We're so low on time. Fortunately, we have some cards that speed up the matchup considerably post-board. Sometimes you gotta grind, right? Sometimes you gotta grind. I think Endurance comes out. The other day I cut some Swords to Plowshares, and I think that was a mistake. Gotta make sure you can answer Emery. Fluster Storms do not come in. They do not have very many targets for Fluster Storm. Yeah, Grinder All-Star, exactly. I think I cut Loam, actually. With the clock situation being what it is. Excavator's still fine. Excavator doesn't take nearly as much time. This is looking okay. I think I might shave a Preordain. We have a lot of answers to Chalice. With the endings and the Knight of Autumns and the Force of Vigor and all that. I do gotta shave something though. Even that could have been fine too. Kind of like Force of Vigor here. It's a little weird, but because they can crack the Boblin response, it's kind of like forcing a Mox Opal. They only have three cards in hand. I think this is fine. Stops them from playing another Emery if they have another one. The funk out my face. Just have six in, getting that F6 value. So we could brainstorm and look for a sword for that Psy, or we could just play the Zoro. I think I want to brainstorm. We could, like, literally bring Uro back next turn, though. Fine. Oh, hello. They did have the Emery. We did slow down the Emery by a turn. Would that force a bigger play? Get the funk out of my face. Come on, prime time. Let's go, prime time. I need two different lands if I want the field to start producing. I think I want the field to start producing. I really want to grab double wasteland and just double waste them, but we have two Trops, so. Oh, let's grab Caracas. Caracas is great here. Mount Psy or Emery or some shit. Looking like a primetime attack is suicidal, huh? Thanks to all those Psy tokens. Might still be worth. Get a lot of zombies to block their saga. Get a couple more wastelands here. We could Yorian blink the primetime and then get an attack in. That's probably better, huh? That's like way better. We have the wasteland here, of course. If we're not attacking with prime time, wasteland first. Oh shit! What up? Oh shit! What up? Hey, Sneal, thanks for 14 months. Not sagging to Psy here, are they? Two mana? They are. Interesting.
Oh shit, what up?
Hey, two live Drew. Thanks for the sub. Thanks for the 7 months there. Thought Mono is really good here. So even without attacking, every turn we can, like, bounce Yorion and loop the prime time that way. Which is not the super fast game that I was hoping for here. We can bring Uro back. I think this is a little bit better. Regret tapping out of swords too. That was unfortunate on my part. I think we chill on the wasteland in case they play another saga. Oh, the chalice would count the swords anyway, sure. Kind of whatever then. Like, fucking chat popping off. I should just say that I'm gonna cast swords, like, over and over. See how chat reacts. Old Shadow Spear. Thank you. Let's go ahead and attack here. Yay. Not the first time I've gotten into time trouble with this deck, but I mean, if you win, it doesn't matter, right? Hey, Big Chimpo, thanks for the 54 months. The matchup's grindy, the deck's grindy. Paid for 25 minutes, gonna use 25 minutes, yeah. Get that full clock value. That second card's pretty great. I'm a fan. Is there a reason we have Null Rod over Collector Oath? I'm dumb. That's the main reason. Should absolutely be Oath in a Green Sun package. Should swap that now before I fucking forget. Norad looks so much cooler. Such a cooler card. Don't want a Green Sun for zero here. That wouldn't be great. How is this better than Lurin? How is a control deck better than a combo deck? Cool. Yeah, looks like Stream Decker's back online. Interesting question. Strifo playing the patented Strifo pile. Alright, Streammaker should be updated now. Considering a bad brainstorm here.
shit, what up?
Oh shit, we're not paying to play. Summoning for 6 months in advance. Greenstone was bad. So made P-Fire alive. Goodness chilled. If I didn't have a removal spell in hand, I would 100% force the Leobold. But I didn't want to punch. I didn't want to pitch the Uro if I could avoid it. I'd like to hold on to that one. Now the question is, do we get Grist rolling or do we play the Uro? Grist actually isn't that good, I don't think. With a MVP fire to like whittle it down. Let's play this hero card. The opponent did something like kind of subtle there. People might not pick up on. You see how they returned the punishing fire with the Uro still on the stack? If you let the Uro resolve, there's a life gain trigger that goes on the stack, and there's a P-Fire trigger. And then if you respond, and then if you decide to use the Uro life gain trigger or the P-Fire or if, and activate the Grove, then activating the Grove gives you another P-Fire trigger. And the issue with that is that you just burning clock, right? And you have to deal with two triggers instead of one. So by responding to the Uro, if you're going to rebuy it anyway. Let's actually fetch first. The wasteland in the bin. So I can play Ending and Grist. Nice. Should've led on the Ending, actually, because if they counter, then I can Hardcast Force Negation. I figured they'd counter the Grist if they had a Force, though. But maybe not. Maybe just not. A little tighter to lead on the Ending. No, my Uro. Ooh, hello. Grist plus Titan is really high, yeah. Should put Yorian to hand. Would have been a good turn for it. This turn. Put him pretty close to getting the row back. Hello. Interesting. They didn't bring back Uro. I think they have a hard cast force. Maybe. They're waiting for me to like play Yorian here. Something along those lines. If the green sun for 3 had resolved, I would have gone Leobold. Sorin the Mirthless coming in hot. Love it. Endurance. I don't think I do. It matters because then I'd be blinking it out with Yorian, right? Seven's actually fierce. What's outside you and inside me? Down a high, truth alive. A weak man's love can be a strong man's cry. Chris can't kill walkers, yeah. I suppose down taking on Sorin there was appropriate. Harder for the Gris to get burned out this way. Mattering. Oh no. God damn it. If you get a plains there, you generate a zombie token. If you get a snow covered island, you feel like an idiot. Well, I wouldn't have been able to make this mistake if I waited on the fetch, huh? We're still good here. A weak man's love can be a strong man's cry. And they do play Deed, so I guess I chill in the Ice Fang. Although, it could cantrip me into a land. Field. I guess I play it. I'm not casting it. Well, yeah, I am. Again, field, right? Well, certainly didn't play that game perfect. There was the early turn that I forgot to rebuy Yorion. That, like, mattered, but then Yorion still ended up being really good. Force Negation lining up against Punishing Fire was really important. I think I want Fluster Storm. I might want Endurance. I know I don't want Knight of Autumn. And I'm skeptical of the number of Swords to Plowshares that I want. I think I want like two. Two or three. Hull Creature is good against deck, yeah. I drew well. Yeah, I mean, the deck's good cards. Whole lot of cards that say draw a card on them. Very difficult to play an entire match optimally with this deck, Squirrel Party, but yeah. The games are grindy, everything's decision dense, and a lot of times you have to sacrifice some equity just in the nature of finishing your match on time, right? Which is fine, if you're ahead. Right now I'm wondering if this Fluster Storm is actually better than, say like an Endurance. I think Endurance might be better. And I'm not sure how many swords I want. Oh shit, what up? Hey, 2XL bud, 6 of the 22 months. Play like one swords. Tropical Island. Resolves, huh? Deciding whether to Ice Fang or Budding Growth here. I think it's Ice Fang. Well, Ice Fang could be a pitch card, right? I kind of like that, actually. Yeah, I'll play the Growth. Yeah, maybe I'm supposed to loam there rather than try and play the wasteland from hand. Be a little bit less vulnerable to endurance. Yeah, deal. Do life totals matter in Legacy? Life totals certainly matter in Legacy. They matter less in Modern, because you're not, like, shocking yourself with your mana base, and there's fewer, like, pure aggro decks. Your life total certainly matters. You can get into dangerous zones with Sylvan Library sometimes. Especially if your opponent's got burn spells, which our opponent in that matchup did. So I wasn't getting, like, too aggressive with Sylvan Library. I also didn't want to, like, overfill my hand for discard, right? And that doesn't make any sense. Pay 4 life to draw a card, and then discard a card isn't nearly as good as pay 4 life, draw a card. This deck can offset the life loss from Sylvan Library really, really nicely with Uro, right? Uro comes into play, gives you 3 life and draws a card. And then Sylvan Library's pay 4 life draw card. And so, really nice use of that resource here. And then, like, if they bump dancers your Uro, then the cards from Sylvan Library help you get the Uro back. It's just a nice little synergy. Glad you're enjoying it, Takase. This deck could be seen as exhausting to play, yeah, that's fair. Fair analysis. The other deck I'm considering is also fucking exhausting to play, Elves. They both have that going for them. Oh, Wizard. We are all suckers in this game of life. Taiga. Who's fetching Taiga? Lands? We're facing lands. It's either like lands or aggro loam, right? Fuck. And here I am without a counter. Yeah, that expiration card really. We have to shuffle this. Loam plus Wasteland is tempting, but it doesn't actually help me win. It doesn't answer the Valakut exploration, which is what we really need right now. Answer to that card in particular. Cracked is a good explanation. I mean, we'll see. We'll see how it plays out. Yep, already unbeatable. Best try here would be Knight. And even that wouldn't be amazing, because they're going to have stage going with Saga soon. But Knight to blow up the exploration would help at least. Prismatic Ending? Yeah, that could do it too. Similar thing, right? Just having an answer. Fetching basics if I can. Can't really anymore. I like the Vista to get Island, but I also like trying to find a relevant card here. The opponent is indeed playing Dark Depths, yeah. They're playing lands.deck, and they have been making 2020s for a minute. Pretty much ever since Thespian Stage got printed. Yeah, lands doesn't really beat combo very often. It also has a rough time with hate cards, right? You could play a card like Back to Basics or Blood Moon or something if you wanted to have a good lands matchup. I was testing out a version of Bank Control with main deck Back to Basics. With that in mind. So I can finally answer that Valakut exploration, but there's some other issues at hand here. So if you use Knight to blow up the Urza Saga, the Thespian Stage can still copy it. And they have Crucible to rebuy. Okay, they're not copying it. Cool. I guess they figure they can just rebuy it with Crucible anyway. They do not have a way to make the 2020 hasty now. Pirate Spell Bomber is interesting. Just want to get Quaddle out of the way. Sure. Sure. We're in a spot where if we can answer the Crucible, we're actually, like, not that terrible. The issue is there's only one Knight of Autumn in the main deck. And I'd kind of like to save the Green Sun for a, prime time if I can get there. If and I can get there, that'd be real swell. Might not be a possible thing. I hate losing the counters, but I think it's necessary. Well, Still a tough game. They have six cards in hand. And my next turn is going to be, like, very unimpressive. Kind of hoping they were gonna use their mana for something else. If I just like took the 3 damage there, and then I could maybe have gotten an extra construct there. Oh, I should have drawn the Force Negation here, because then I could hard cast it, huh? I guess I'm just putting Yori into hand. Not ideal. Pitches to Force, I suppose. They don't play the Trample Giver, right? Needle on Crocus. Makes sense. That's not wrong. If you needle Misty, I mean, I could still tap for a green from the Yabamaya. So it's not the best needle hit. We know the top card of our library. I'd love to save this fetch for post-prime time, but knowing the top card of our library, I think we just gotta fetch here. Great. Actually, head on time. Oh, no, I'm not. I get two tokens. Yeah. Not yet. Or wait, no, they can't copy Dark Depths, right? Yeah, because of the Yabamaya, the Dark Depths taps for mana. Alright, I am just dead then. there a line for me to not die this turn? I think it involves getting either Uro or Quaddle, right? I think I gotta get Quaddle. It's so unlikely though, because Quaddle can chump, but then you still have to deal with three Karnstrucks. It's like kind of an impossible thing. Oh well, let's see. Force of Vigor comes in, second Knight comes in. Hopefully the explanation for those should be pretty obvious after the last game. Teferi's gonna come in. Teferi's pretty good at bouncing Saga. It's kind of nice. Or tokens if you can force them to do it on your turn. I don't think any of the rest of this makes sense. Maybe Endurance. If you play Lull, and it can block 2020s. The issue is, like, what are we cutting, right? What are we cutting for these cards? I think Leibold comes out. Leibold's kind of good if they're trying to, like, wasteland you and stuff. But I think it comes out. You gotta cut stuff. You want to leave some number of swords in to answer 2020s. Bant Ephemerae. I think the deck's good. The deck's too hard for me. It gives me a headache when I play it. Mm. Grist is awful here. Yeah, let's cut that one too. Should I cut the Bayou? It feels weird cutting a land against the Wasteland deck, but if we cut both the Black Splash entirely, I think it's reasonable. Nah, I wouldn't cut Brids. Chromia's really good, yeah. Super good, super fun. Yeah, the only thing is like whether I want like one more Endurance in here, which I kind of do, but I don't know what to cut, so I'm just not gonna play it, I think. Well, when you're taking Salty Ninja, when you're taking a 60-card deck and making an 80-card deck, remember that you're like diluting some of the numbers. So if you still want, the what would normally be 8 cantrips in a 60-card deck, you're gonna want more cantrips in an 80-card deck without those draws. We do have the Enchant Land though, does something similar. One issue with Snapcaster is that it's kind of fighting with Uro, right? Sometimes you have a empty graveyard, and that's no fun. Yeah, I think just like actual cantrips are good. You want some stuff going to the graveyard. A few different options here. Like you could green sun for 0. I think you would fetch Trop if you did that, and then try and set up like Brainstorm into something sweet. Then you're fetching yourself off of white for the Night of Autumn. I kind of like the idea of going green sun for birds next turn off of a basic forest. Nice. Tabernacle makes birds a little bit worse. Still fix real nice. Stevie Wonder is not DMCA free, Oishi. I'm playing one of my old playlists right now. Absolutely do not, Netman. Because I've got Quaddles, Stinky Tommy. I've got Quaddles. And them, like, not having Death Touch comes up more often than not making a random 2-2. Feel the Dead's like a late-game card. You don't need to, like, maximize it to its fullest. It's very often good enough. Playing Primeval Titan and getting two lands to get the field, which is usually how you get it. Four endings is too many. I definitely wish I had an endurance here. I'm gonna let Knight die. Green Sun for 0 is so bad against Tabernacle. I guess I shuffle one of them away, huh? Then I don't know if I'm gonna grab or a 2-3 that revives lands, maybe. I think I'm supposed to get endurance to hit their loam. For now, they have the ability to make a 20/20 next turn, though. Kind of an issue. Might end up regretting shuffling away that prismatic ending and keeping this horse bigger. It's not doing anything. I guess endurance chomps for a turn. Sure. Yep. I don't know what they want here. Maybe Yavamayam. Yeah, they already have the Dark Depths in their hand. They actually don't have to pay one for the 2020, because Tabernacle's destroy, not sacrifice. Certainly tempting here.
Oh shit, what up?
Hey, X-Star. Thanks for the sub. Thanks for 15 months. I'll pass on the attacking. How's it going? We already seen a crop rotation or two, so I thought there was a chance. There's a chance I could get her all rolling there. Would've been nice. Draw into like, you know, removal. I'm actually not in the worst spot. If we'd gotten the Uro back, we would be able to take a Marilage hit too. We'd be at 23 then. Life's full of ups and downs. You got to find your own high ground. Mother Wit is your connection. Use it for your protection. You got to dance to it. Yeah, let's ponder. Wasteland into play right now, but then we have to pitch the prime time to Force of Vigor, which I really don't want to do. Yeah, fuck that Tryhard. Having Wasteland is, like, real nice versus the onboard Thespian stage. We're going to be answering the Crucible, of course. It's like whether to play around a second Dark Depths or not. The issue with pitching Quaddle is then we don't draw this Wasteland, right? There's Wasteland on top of our library. They're giving them an opening to make a 20-20 that you don't necessarily need to do. We do not have a second Endurance, nor does that card matter here. We're not playing anything from the graveyard. We're killing this Crucible. We are killing the Crucible with the Force of Vigor one way or the other. I don't regret this shit. Eclipse Knight? I didn't even know Eclipse Knight was a thing. I should have just done the damn Quaddle thing. Hey, Blue Double Boxer, thanks for 11 months. You're very welcome. We knew about the Wasteland in their hand. I should put your in the hand there. I can do it next turn, probably. Unlikely I can find something that uses up my whole turn. Doesn't work. Playing the Quaddle and drawing a Wasteland, that turn that I tanked on for a billion years? Why would it not work? The effect on the birds is my opponent's Tabernacle. Land I crave. I don't think I play Yorian. I think I wait. They had Pyroblast. Why do you keep on talking about Pyroblast? We don't know that they have a Pyroblast in hand. Yeah, that's cool. Actually saves me a lot of time on the clock, huh? Come on. one, yes. I think we lost field earlier, but getting a 6-6 that grabs wastelands still seems awesome. Yeah, let's grab double waste. Get a pyroblast? How would they have gotten a why? I'm just gonna play. I'm short on time. You can try and backtrack why you think they have a pyroblast in hand. To your heart's content. I think Bonnet is just frustrated with the triple Mox Diamond draw here. Sweet. I'm so good at plays around the Pyroblast in their hand. The other card that they super had for some reason. Alright, game three, 8 minutes on the clock. I want to bring in some Endurance action. That's what I want. I don't know if I want all three, but I definitely want a second copy. What an annoying game, huh? Oh, I wonder if Hydro Blast is good. They definitely play four of that bullshit enchantment. Could a Hydro Blast or Pyroblast. The perfect plan. I literally can't fit my whole sideboard on one line right now. Almost all one ofs. That's a good point. They'd be able to Pyroblast my Hydro Blast. Maybe that is a bad board in. Seems awful, but I kind of want to cut the loam, because I'm once again in time trouble. This is not the matchup that you cut loam in, though, huh? Not the right one for that. Yeah, this is all okay. I don't hate the third Endurance, I don't hate the Hydro Blast, but... I don't think I'll Preordain for Hydro Blast. Try that out. Testing ground. Is this Hydro Blast good or not? They did dredge a Pyroblast, but that doesn't mean they have a Pyroblast in their hand. That's not how that card works. Exploration Resolve. I'd save the forest for loam or something.
Yeah.
Vist also very reasonable here. When it did maul, yeah. Too worried about this endurance. A second one would have been some good pressure. Thrilled about this port. It's a little scarier. Should maybe get paid for there. I think I might cast a bad brainstorm on their end of turn. So get a card in the graveyard for the Uro here. Mana base is being pressured a little bit by this port. Nice. Love all of this. God, I only have 5 minutes to end the game. I should probably play quickly. I'm them activating the port meant that they couldn't activate their Thespian stage in response to Wasteland to copy a basic, which is the real concern there. Real concern. The bog here is rough, because it gets rid of my Uro, so I have to find some other way to win this game. We've successfully stopped them from killing me, but now I need to kill them somehow.
I got cash in fuck you quantities.
Yeah.
Now what? That makes you uncomfortable.
Alright, Sylvan Library, give me the juice.
And the Range Rover you drove in on. Fuck your Saab convertible, and fuck your twice weekly trips to the analyst. Stupid motherfucker.
Yeah, alright.
Fuck the Hamptons, Maine, and blindfested south of France. I'm paid asshole. Got more cash than God can count, so why don't you just die?
No punishing fire blocks. I think they would kill the bird.
Choke to death on your damn designer bagel from Baldouches. No cholesterol, naturally. Fuck your big old Sunday New York Times. Fuck the Wall Street Journal and Newsweek and the lot. Including Nation, Village Voice, Guardian, and the rest. Stupid set of privileged motherfuckers. Think it's fashionable to have
a second expiration. Shuffled, but whatever.
Caffeine limiting, sodium sparing, NutraSweet sweetening, rear view mirror preening.
Should have plenty of time here.
Nibbling bunny. Go drown in a lake of
dust. Let's fetch now and think about it.
Fucker.
Respond there because the exploration, yeah.
Cash. Mega cash.
But it's not playing. Okay, whatever. Still playing on the endurance.
Oh, go sit on your ski rack. Money talks, you little pussy.
And they do draw punishing fire. We do have swords, of course.
But I think you're a dick.
Eat some life in response.
Multiculturalism. Japanese restaurant on Monday. Indian on Tuesday. And on Wednesday, Caribbean. Not too spicy, please.
Not too spicy?
Well, I got stash on stash and it ain't nouveau cash. Money's in my family for generations. My great, great, great grandfather made the bag selling European slaves in Africa. I got cash, motherfucker. And you can't tell whether or not I'm joking, can you? Dumb fuck.
That song's got a nice energy to it, doesn't it? The port to save a life. Love it. Love that port. I think we got him, folks. I think we got him. Never come back home. I've been bogged. So we got a little lucky that one game in particular where they drew like three Mox Diamonds or whatever when they really needed some action. It's like the lands equivalent to being flooded, huh? Drawing all your Mox Diamonds when you don't have stuff. But the important parts were there, and like Force Negation on Loam ended up being pretty important that last game. Bath and break and a drink. I'm good now. Maybe after the next round. But good suggestion, Dr. Doom. MTG Border Eraser, thanks for the 34 months. I think I need a cigarette after that one. So that's what I need. I don't even smoke. Holy shit. Some good control nonsense. Are there still Tendrils decks? There are still Tendrils decks. A lot of those players moved over to Doomsday. And yeah, fast combo isn't our best matchup. There's a reason that I'm sideboarding Meddling Mage, Canonist, like all that shit, right? How good is Primetime in this deck? It's very good in this deck. You get into these like sloggy control mirrors. And Primetime is what you give with Green Sun Zenith to close the game out at the end. Gives you some nice inevitability. I tested, people were messing around with Fuel of the Dead in like regular band control or in like four color control without a Green Sun package, and I kind of hated it because you would draw it, you draw it naturally like a good chunk of the time, and if you're drawing it naturally you have this shitty like comes to play tap land that like eventually starts making 2/2s or whatever. It's just like miserably slow and clunky. But with the Primetime in the deck, with Primeval Titan in the deck, you can just have the Field of the Dead every time you need it, which is the late game. Your Green Sun Zenith just turns into an army. The Primeval Titan's basically like a Grave Titan, right? They can also grab utility lands. So this has been much, much better. Eternal Weekend Legacy event, there's three of them. And the times, you can just Google them. Let me see if I can get you the article. Oh, Red 7 already got it, nice. Yeah, the one I'm playing in for sure starts, my regular stream time start tomorrow. Quite nice. And then the Bayou event starts at 4 in the morning my time, which is, I mean, I'll be awake, but. And then the Sylvan Library starts at noon, which I don't think I'm going to be up for. I think I'm only going to be able to play in the Wasteland event. Unless I want to stay up and play at 4 in the morning. Maybe I'll see how many people are in it. How many rounds of Swiss? If we had a cantrip, I would like this hand. Leave one of the, if either like Primetime or Green Sun or the ending, if any of that shit was a cantrip, then we could like fetch Trop and Green Sun for zero and being a good spot to hit lane number two. With this, if we whiff on lane number two, we're just like green sending for bird on two, which I don't actually like with this deck at all. We want to hit our land drops. This is better. Big shout out to the mods for stepping up. I've been playing like a lot of meticulous games today and haven't been able to like field a lot of chat questions. I've noticed mods doing that work. Love y'all. Stream would not work without them. I think I could handle a lot of it if I was playing a deck that I'd like played infinite before in a less sequencing intensive format, right? If I was playing some mindless deck or whatever, then I'd be interacting with chat more and all that fun business. But when you're playing a deck that like goes to time trouble a lot, kind of just gotta play. Unless you want to lose. I don't want to lose. I wonder if they would have forced negation with Loam if I'd let on Loam. Probably, huh? They wouldn't have force willed it though. It wouldn't have baited force of will. Well, hate this. Hate all of this. Need a brainstorm. I'm gonna figure this hand out, huh? That I wanted to try out in the control mirror. And we'll play a second copy of Endurance. Knight of Autumn does blow up Sylvan Library. Is that enough of a reason to run Knight of Autumn? Folks, we were like, I think less than 5% to win that game from where we were at. We could still technically win. A lot of that ability is based on whether we hit, Brainstorm to answer the Uro in the near future. But, like, then playing the Uro and then getting it back. If we're spending our turn, like, putting Yorion to hand and then casting Yorion, like, the Uro's kind of already run away with the game. So I was fine just moving right along, huh? Just moving right along. I don't think I want the third endurance. Maybe I do. Sure is a nice answer to Uro. Yeah, alright. Planeswalkers are good. Next arm. Planeswalkers in general are good in control mirrors. Fuck it. 81, let's go. It's got some potential. Saving time, yeah, I saved a lot of time. Definitely not gonna lose this game to the clock. The opponent also is also not. Maybe that's a reason to play that last game out. I'll just be like F6ing on my turns. The opponent will have to deal with like row triggers and stuff. Keeping most of this. Yeah, let's go ahead and shuffle away one of the fetches. But let's just wasteland this turn. I think I'm just gonna get another forest. And casting Priority in here wouldn't be crazy. But so is not. I mean, it's fine to not. I think if you cast Priority in here, then there's a chance that you have to put Yori into hand next turn. To have the blue card Force of Will. Made Prime Time make the cut in Legacy. Well, this is a Green Sun Zenith deck with a field as its late game win condition, so the Prime Time fits very well in that shell. Prime Time's shown up in other places before. I played it in doing something very similar with Battle Wits. I had a Green Sun Zenith package in that deck. Storming off here. I don't think Field was around when I was playing Battle Wits, but you would just go and get like Dark Depths plus Thespian Stage. Got me. Highly unfortunate with us missing a land drop there. I was hoping we would get to resolve and rebuy Wasteland, hit our land drop, and then also disrupt them in the process. And now here we are without a counter, which is a real bummer. Yeah, loam it up. Tempting. I'm gonna grab Leopold. Grist also kind of tempting here, huh? Fuck. Lone Vine and Caracas is really awkward because it means that they can bounce the Leopold and do everything that they want to do. Oh, they're just jamming Uro into the Leo? Well, that's fucking great for me. 3 mana, put a land into play. My Uro in the graveyard. Pass here. I kind of hate the idea of pitching the prime time to play the endurance. I kind of loathe that idea. But it would get answer the Uro and the Loam. I just need one more land, though, you know? I just need one more fucking land. And we have this Teferi down. I'm just gonna pass. Interesting spot. Sure. Both players have their obnoxious hate pieces. Witherbloom Command. That can hit graveyards, right? That's why they still have it in. Target player mills 3. Then you may return a land from your graveyard to your hand, or you can destroy a non-creature, non-land permanent with mana value 2 or less. Okay. So that can hit Sylvan Library, actually. Target creature gets minus 3, minus 1, so I can kill a Quaddle. Or you can drain for 2. So drain's probably not going to be relevant unless they literally only have one thing. Can't draw the card because of the Narset. I see. Touché opponent. Also, I fetched all my basics and then drew Prismatic Vista. This is all of them, right? Are there just five? God damn it, meme. I got so excited to draw the Vista. I was like, yes, the sixth land I needed for prime time. This is literally the first time this has happened. This is so embarrassing. Guess I should have fetched a duel at some point earlier, huh? So I guess I'm just like casting Endurance, huh? Cast Endurance past turn. It's not great, but... it's got Flash, but why do I want them to dredge Loam? What am I flashing in? You could play it on their upkeep. I could. You are correct. Sandbagging the Vista. Coming in clutch already. This would be a lot better if I had a Leovold in play. That's all I gotta say. That's all I gotta say. No, don't do it a third time! That's unfortunate! So cruel. Wish I had back to basics. Yeah, I think if I could have slammed primetime there, I'd be favored, but because I couldn't, I'm like super not. Excavators in the graveyard. Uru was awkward against the outboard Caracas and the Narset, right? Well, let's get Grist. We do not have another Leo, no. We could also get Endurance. If I was gonna get Endurance, though, I should be doing it on their turn. Just get that Raven's Crime. I think Grist is good. No, my Hull Breacher. That Breacher would have been excellent against this Jace. There are two more Endurances, yeah. Well met, Pokemon Team. Well met. Put it at a real grasp of that control mirror. I imagine they played against this specific deck a few times, with everybody testing it out for the Eternal Weekend. Not going to time, no. Nowhere close. Yeah. Mystic Sanctuary is kind of hot. Turn your fetches into vamps in the late game. It was definitely a beating, Eric Virgo. No disrespect taken. I very much agree. Oh, thanks, FPS. Man, I'm feeling the disrespect right now. It's alright. Feeding off of it. Porno's not a mold of four. They're gonna try and oops all spells me. They're gonna have a rough time here, I think. I don't think anyone would call me the Doctor of Disrespect. I think that name's already taken. Taken by someone who was literally banned from Twitch for live streaming someone else in a bathroom. Disrespectful AF. On Narcomoeba. They don't cast Narcomoeba. It was one of the reasons they'd been banned earlier, Sylva the Great. The like actual reason for the lifetime ban is not public. But I imagine the lifetime ban wouldn't have happened if there hadn't been earlier incidents, right? Yeah, so I think I'm just GMing, like, random blue cards for the pitch casts. I don't think Force of Vigor does anything. Actually, maybe Loam's better than Leovold. Wasteland? No, that's not gonna matter. Sweet. I'm doing pretty well. We'll keep watching. Doing pretty well. I'm like 8-1 in the evening. Feeling pretty good about Eternal Weekend tomorrow. I am not going to be playing Dragon Stompy. This is not a deck I'm gonna register. This is interesting. The matchup is such that like we're actually gonna bin our mana development cards. I was thinking keep the Ice Fang because it pitches to either. But maybe I pitch it. No, I think this is right. We'll hit two lands eventually. I'm still not 100%, we'll keep watching. I think I'm gonna play either Elves or this, I think. I think Elves is good against the style of deck that I'm playing right now. I think there's a lot of people testing this trash. I'd known that I was gonna draw Uro. I would have kept that green sun. The Death and Taxes matchup, it's not the best. It's a little bit better than like old Bank Controls was. Green Sun Zenith package helps a bit. And then you also have the Plague Engineers out of the board are kind of nice. Is nice. Suppose. So between yesterday and today, we went 9-1 with this deck. Not bad. Not bad records.